Welcome to race number 16 here at Springfield, Illinois. The dirt track, the one and only dirt track race of the season. The ARC Series does race at this track in real life, so let's try it out in NR. Matt Dalio and Colin Dreibert on the front row. Here's your full qualifying results. We'll now take you to trackside. This should be fun, hopefully. Guardrails and stuff.
Drivers, start your engines.
All right, here we go. Oh, this is a local racetrack. This is our first dirt track we've raced in the entire league. First time. That's just a glitch. Don't have to worry there. And oh, we got a car smoking. That's a 67. Timothy Needham's already smoking. 99 already turned around. We crawl off the start, and now the double zero is around, and we got ourselves a record. That didn't go as planned. So we're calling off the start. We're calling off the start. This is the second time this happened this season. So we'll go by next time. So this is bad for the 67. Three car just got turned around. Oh, and the doubles are right behind. Oh my god, we already... What is going on? Not this again. This happened in the convertible series. That did not take long. Race didn't even start, and we already have double zero completely wrecked. 67 is out for a mechanical problem. Brandon stopped on the racetrack. They gotta call it the start here. The double zero's lost everything. They're gonna go green this time. Not good. Keep an eye on that pace car. Okay, he's on pit road. Again. Yeah, we're gonna start on the back strip from now on. We can't start on pit road no more. Race should have been on by now, but here we go. Green flag is out, and we're underway. Four wide to turn one. AJ Green, little bump and run. Three wide for the lead. They're all over the place on this third track. Might have an underdog, and we already have a wreck. I think. Just saw a car just spin. Yeah, yellow's out. AJ Green in a 22 car will take the lead. Man, what a mess that was. Let's take a look at the replay. So, here's a replay. Let's take a look at what happened. Oh, the 88. Causing another big wreck. That flipped the 20 car over only once. If he was the only one involved, he would have been tumbling. So, just gotta thank those drivers getting involved as well. There's Tony Green just grinding the wall there. Ken Derone, the 66, involved in another wreck. He had nowhere to go. He was boxed in no matter what. He was gonna be involved. 98 collected as well. Tristan Barker, one of the championship contenders, cannot afford to wreck. There's over 100 points Calvin is leading. So you better close that gap. Take a look at that contact with the 88. I don't think it was his fault. Well, it could have been, but he might have got pushed. Let's see. Right at chase cam. Carter's pushing him. Pushing. Oh, yep. Yeah, he gave a shot. Right at the back. So it wasn't the 88's fault. Carter caused that one. So there's your first yellow of the day. We'll take you back. Alright, lights are off. Coming to the green. Two cars out of the race. The 74 tire go down. 38. Blue is out. 98 is out. 20 car somewhere. 59's off the road. 20's still out there. I saw the 74 have some sort of problem at the start. Once the green flag rolled. Waved. low word. Yeah, some problem. Pulled out of the group. Went all the way inside the wall. Something went wrong. So two cars didn't start the race, the 67 and the 00. Me and him had something go bad. I don't know what it was, and the 00 slams on the line of Costa, who got turned around for some reason. AJ Green, who dominated Boston but got taken out. Few laps left, cost him the race, cost him a top 5. Not won a race so far. Still got this, and then the next two. Springfield, Illinois. Pat Neal, although his back bumper trying to return the favor, he bumped and run him at the start. He's trying to do the same thing. I think the caution is out. Pit road is closed. Yeah, I think so. Saw the light go off. Caution. Yep, there it is. Yellow's out. For the second time, what happened? Must have been like maybe a skin or something. We'll take a look at the replay. Yep, Chris Kyle in the 20, who went upside down in turns 3 and 4, he got dumped by the 66, who also got caught up in that wreck. Both cars have their hoods torn off, had him sideways off turn 2, and then finally turned him around. He ended up going around himself as well. And there was no reason to call yellow for this. Doesn't look that bad. 20 car dead driver back to pit road. And that's about it. So there's your second yellow of the day. We'll take you back. Alright, lights are off. Come to the green. 29 cars remain on the racetrack. This is bad. Got the 20 car on the inside, one lap down. There's a lot of space between the 3 lap cars and the 20. Plenty of room. But still, this is the dirt track. You can use the whole track if you want. Green flag. Good start for AJ Green. Cars to 20 at the start. 4 wide. Cause a big stack up. 15 car might dump him. But we're going at it again. Pretty fast here today, of course, but great to see these cars on dirt. Let's go back to the old days. Third place is Angiorillo, he's in fourth. Abadelio in 36th, fifth. Cameron 6th, Dryburgh 7th. Top 10 would be great for him. Of course, he can do everything he can to get all the positions possible. Oh, still blocking a couple drivers. The 80 cars worked his way up. He's passing a few, but didn't need more. The 42 is there. Of course, finish ahead, you'll gain some points, but you gain more than that. He does have, actually, he doesn't really look like he has any damage. Front end, Matt Neely has finally gotten him. He was pretty close at the line. Matt Neely to the front. Both drivers did not want to race this season. Hoping to get one here today at Springfield. There's Angiorillo third. He has a good gap between himself and the 36 of Josh Neely. 52 car, moving up to 5th. Car and driver all over the back bumper of his teammate. Just don't wreck him, and he makes a clean pass. Colin doing everything he can. Gotta get as much position as possible. Trying to win the damn race. Aggressive. Can't waste any time. You can't flag off in any race. From Daytona to Homestead. Gotta keep going. I know Arca ends in Kansas, but in this series, we end at Homestead. We did it the last two seasons, and yeah, do it again. Pat Mayo has a good lead, good comfortable lead. It looks pretty damn comfortable. He's probably going to lead a few. AJ might get him back. He's going to lead a few. Maybe third place can try. Oh, nope. Caution. Got a caution. Race it back. Coming to the line, it will be Matt Dalio. He crosses the line first. Caution's out for the third time. Alright, Dylan Darrow in a 72 car. He was 17th. Tough season. Taylor Acosta, a little bump on the left side. Had him sideways for a bit. And then there he went. Right in front of the 99. I know Tony Green got a piece of that. So did the 25. I know Coburn. Save it. Ah, just hit the wall. Didn't look too bad. So that brings out our third caution of the day. That sends Dylan Darrow all the way to 28th after running in the top 20. Tough season. Very tough season for the 72. Well, let's take you back to the restart. Alright, lights are off. Come to the green. Now we got three cars on the inside. All lapped down. 20, the 72, and now 25. Three cars. This could either cause a big wreck or slow everyone down. Well, it worked out the first time. Now we've got three. What does this mean? I don't know. Here we go, green flag. The 72 is still fast, four wide. He got rear end damage, but he's still going. Look at the contact back there. First keep on his team there. 78 car contact. The 15 might have gotten this time. He saved it. Wow, that would have been huge. Crazy racing here at Springfield. It's just insane. The top three remain the same since, I don't know what happened, but not really the same. Dalio did get the lead back. Andrew Rowe kind of overshot the corner, but it got a big gap, big cushion. And chased that 22 car down. Take a look back there. Colin down the fifth, his teammate got him. He's going to go by Dylan Darrow in the 72 car. This car is still here. How the hell is that possible? Oh, we got a crash. Someone just spun. Yellow's out. Yep, caution is out. I'm just scrolling through the drivers way too fast. I know. I do that a lot. Been doing that since the beginning, I think. Yellow's out. We'll take a look at the replay. Just a simple spin. Once again, it's the 66 who's the one who dumped someone off turn two, but this time he didn't wreck his own car. He just took him out, and again, I don't think there was any reason for a caution to be called. He barely hit the guardrail. And that was about it. Another unnecessary caution. We'll take you back. Alright, here we go. 29 cars still remaining. Chase cars already in. Matt Dalio. Green flag. Back underway. Let's see that 72 car can get a lap back. Yeah, no, he's not. Top two just cleared him once they enter turn one. Look at Colin Dreiberg. He's gonna take advantage of this. He might take third from these guys. And he clears. Roll down to fourth. Oh, got trouble. Sam Curtis back there got turned around. Yellow. Again, fifth caution. Another caution flag. And they're still going at it back there. They're not done. A lot of angry drivers. Probably might have like 10 drivers trying to punch another after this one. Yellow's out. We'll take a look at the replay once again. Rusty Bobninski in the 78th. He takes out the 56th Sam Curtis. He was 6th when he crossed the line. Lost a few. Rusty was not having it. He's racing for a championship and he just flat out took him out. And of course, get a breather here to restart single file. Give him another chance so I can get those spots back. One of the reasons he probably dumped Sam Curtis. But of course, Curtis not going to be happy. Forgot where he is in the standings. He's somewhere. But anyways, let's take you back to the restart. Alright, lights are off once again. 29 cars still remaining on the racetrack. Only one big wreck. But it might have more. Perhaps closing down. Restart. Double Colin Driver, get up to third. Might be a major contender in this. Gonna cut Callington's points lead in half. Green flag is back. We're back underway. All stack up because of the lap cars. 72 trying to get by. Go again. Close. George Roke almost got dumped on a 99. I don't think this is the perfect cut for retaliation either. What if he flips? That would be bad. Would be really bad. AJ Green to the low side. Ah. Here he goes. We might drag race. Nope. Tucks right behind the 10 car again. Colin Driver to the 55. He looks. A bump and run again, maybe? Not close enough. Daly is doing everything he can to hold him back. Don't mirror drive now. You might take yourself out. AJ Green again to the inside. Both cars looking for their first of the season. And oh, got big pileup. Here we go. Now we got ourselves a wreck. AJ overshot. Overshoots the corner to the outside. Not gonna work, never gonna work. Mostly power slide, maybe, but not with these cars. Again, we got ourselves a caution. Got a big pile up at the back. Taking out a few. Alright, let's take a look at the replay. Matt Naylor in the race leader. Okay, this time the 88. This time he took someone out for sure. Hooked the 78, Rusty Bobninski off turn 2. Got him to the guardrail. Michael Dalio was well involved. And then the 52, he made it through. Jesse Turner trying to squeeze on the outside. Wasn't going to work. Not going to work at all. He gets in the 78 hard. They just all pile in. And Ryan Needham around as well. Coburn back there. Kevin Carter. And there's Turner again. Boy, this is not good. Not good at all for him. With two races left, you think he could still win it? Maybe. Let's ride on board. He almost got it. The 78 didn't slide up. He hit the guardrail into the guardrail pretty hard. I think he got turned around again. Put even more damage. And then here comes Kevin Carter in the 77. Man. So the 80 made it out. 42 made it out. And he's in the top 10. Even more pressure for Colin Dryberg. So, not a big pileup, but still a pileup. Yeah, that was dumb to say. I don't know. I got nothing else to say. We'll take you back to the restart. Coming to the green here, we got even more lap cars on the inside. 4 of them. Okay, no, not really more, just added one, but still. 24 cars remaining on the lead lap. Got the one car out of line, might go to pit room. DJ Curtis got dumped earlier. Now on the outside. Now back to the inside. He's 10th right now. He has to make an unscheduled pit stop. Once he rips his way up to the of the 10th. He has to pull down. Green flag is out. AJ to the outside. Galio to the outside. Call him the second. Oh, sideways. Ken DeRoe, did you see that? What a save. And on dirt, too, and on the flat. Crazy. Still bunching up. Matt Dalio with a huge lead. Colin the second. Dalio the third. AJ falls to fourth. Fifth place is Taylor Acosta being pushed by John Acosta. Whoa! Bit too hard. Really had to hit the brakes there. Could have slammed into the 72. They kept going. The 80 car has gotten by the 42 car. Calvin being held back by the 20. He might turn him. Still holding him back. Can't allow this to happen. We got Sam Curtis, his teammate. He might help him down the back and front and back stretch. Or he is just only a spot ahead. Is it? Or just ahead of the 42? Yeah, that's what she said. Dalio with a huge lead, coming to 10 to go. The caution comes out, lap cars will have to start single file like everyone else. And of course, no one wants that. Unless you got no one, but that lap car is holding it. Never mind. 10 to go. Colin Driver closing in just half a second. I think he's closing in. Closing in on DJ Curtis now, the 48. He's not slow, though. I don't think he'll be a factor. It's crazy. We only had 2 leaders today. Well, not everyone knows how to race on dirt. Just like a road course. Not everyone knows how to race on a road course. So it's different. Sometimes you get the underdogs to have a shot at winning this thing. Look at the first of the season, Matt Dalio in the 10. Colin Driver has a real fast race car, but Matt Dalio has led the most laps. Driver needs to win. Matt Dalio wants to win too. He doesn't care if he's going for the champion, he's going for that checkered flag. It doesn't matter to him. He wants a caution, late caution. Well, if a caution comes out now, then we keep going. Then we will have a restart. Colin is just closing. Take a look at the back. I hope we don't get any more cautions. The way it looks, man, they're just going at it. They're not stopping at all. Let's see where they are now. 42 making some gains. Either he fell back or the 80 went up. He's 7th. Galvin 10th. Now 9th. Aureus the 6th. Colin closing in. 0.29 seconds. I don't think DJ Curtis will be a factor. Colin Driver's hitting way too hard that time. He's going to lose some momentum. Six to go. We will still have time and the caution comes out now. Hopefully it stays green. Or get a caution right now. Have everyone bunch up. Get a good finish. Matt Dalio to the inside of DJ Curtis. He goes by, small drag, allows Colin to close in just a bit. And now he's held back by the 48.32. He lost a bit. If the caution comes out now, then it'll be over. I think so. There's the drivers at the back of the pack. Looks okay for now. Calvin's still 9th, Aureus is still 6th. Colin's still trying to get that lead. He looks a bit lower that time. 0.33 seconds. 36 car, 1 second behind. 2 seconds for 4th, and two almost 2.5 for 5th. 3 seconds, 9th place. Colin tries to get some sort of run on the outside, but it's not working. Work that low side. Second place, not enough. Gotta get the most points. But if Colin wins this race, then it'll be tied if Matt Dalio finishes second, because he's got the most laps. 3 laps remaining. Who's gonna win this race? What will happen? Anything can happen. Oris is up to 5th right now. Calvin is up to 8th. So both drivers gained a position. 2 to go. Left at Springfield. Small gain that time. Whoop. Camera glitch. Don't want to lose this one after leading the most laps. Colin has to try something. Gotta get that victory. But Matt Neal is gonna do everything he can. Coming to the white flag. White flag is out one more time around. We will finish under green. Gonna drive it in pretty hard. Oh, a bit too hard. He looks a bit lower. Matt Neal looks a bit high. I don't think that's enough though. No pressure from behind. Commented a checkered flag. Looks like it will be Matt Daly in the 10 car. Here we go. Checkered flag is out. Matt Daly. And what a fail I just did. Trying to do that no camp thing. And oh. Who got him? Calvin got him? Nope. One spot short. Oh man, they're just going at AJ Green. Who we thought would be a major contender. Finishes 5th. Another chance to win it. Fade to win. And a chance. I don't know what I'm saying again. A little contact. And F42, man, he raced hard at the end. He did everything he can to stop Roy from gaining, but he finishes 6th. He'll take 7th. Michael Daly just missed pit road as well as another couple cars. And oh! And he almost goes upside down. We'll take a look at the Flores results. Wow. What a race. Wasn't no photo finish or anything like that. Only had 2 leaders, but real fun to see those drivers really hit the dirt track and drive it. You know, be aggressive. Go 4 wide and not wreck. And all that good stuff. Colin Dryberg, 1 spot short. Finishes 2nd. Daly 3rd. Taylor 4th. AJ 5th. Aureus lost 1 spot. He was 5th. And then he fell to 6th. Alright, the game crashed, so we're going to have to look at the Flores results on score 4. Matt Neal, Colin Dryberg, Joshua Neal, Taylor Acosta, AJ Green, Aureus, Calvin Lind, John Acosta, Jay Richardson, and Andrew Rolo. That's your top 10. And look how close Calvin Lind was to beating Aureus. Look at that interval. Man, that's crazy. Just shows you how hard he was racing at the end. Doing everything he can to extend his points lead on Aureus, who's still, I think, maybe still 2nd in points, but we'll take a look at that. Since the game crashed, no victory lane. So, on to the points.